Welcome back. The Philippine Central Bank is working on launching its wholesale digital currency project dubbed Project Aguila. Senior Assistant Governor Ed Navilla gave some updates on the initiative at the 2023 Singapore FinTech Festival. Salve Duplito has this exclusive interview from the sidelines of the event.
Ms. Edda, I'm so honored that you gave me your first media interview. Now, CBDC is a novel idea, and it's a lot of central banks across the world are already moving in this direction. But my challenge for you today is to explain what this is in less than 2 minutes.
Okay. Good evening, and again, first, thank you very much for this interview and for us to be able to explain to you a little bit of what we do in Central Bank. Thank you. So CBDC, or Central Bank Digital Currency, is the digital representation of the money that we know. So it has the complete backing of the central bank.
Mm-hmm. That's basic knowledge that not a lot of people know. They think it's similar to the digital currencies, the blockchain, the Bitcoin, okay. Ethereum, but this is something that is seen to provide more stability in the movement to digital currency. Now, the question is how different it is, because the money that we have now, we send it electronically. So a lot of people are thinking it's already digital. What's the difference?
So the project that we have, we call it Project Aguila. It is actually to test wholesale central bank digital currencies. There are two kinds of central bank digital currencies, one retail and the other one is wholesale.
Mm-hmm.
So we have decided to do wholesale central bank digital currencies. And that's the basic goal of what we wanted to find out, is whether we could use that while the regular real-time gross settlement system is closed.
This is the RTGS.
Or it's called Phil Pass Plus.
Okay, that works only within 8 to...
There's actually 9 to 5.
9 to 5
so
every day.
If we have a CBDC, we were thinking maybe that could work outside of the regular 9 to 5 hours. So you could have settlement outside.
Okay, the RTGS is used for certain things like
for large value
transfers,
yes.
Right? So an example of that would be trade,
mm-hmm.
And equities. I know that this is part of the equity settlement. Could be one of the use cases that
could
you're
be,
thinking.
Could be. Right now, equities are not settled in central bank money. So if we are successful in actually learning more about CBDC, maybe that is some use case that we could actually engage in.
So on the retail side, not much value right now. But on the wholesale side, that's where you see a lot of value in creating a CBDC. What other use cases are there for a wholesale CBDC aside from equities, for example?
For improving intraday settlement in the real-time gross settlement, that's one. And also for cross-border payments. This, as well as the equities, those are the three things that we are thinking of. But for our project, Aguila, which is the pilot test for CBDC, we just want to test whether we could actually do interbank transfers between banks and non-banks.
Mm-hmm. And the benefit of this is, I know that there is benefit in cost, right? And speed. Can you explain more about that?
We were hoping that with the CBDC, it will make the RTGS even more stable, which will then encourage fintech providers, for example, to be confident that our payment system, the national payment system in general, is robust. And hopefully that will create products that will then improve speed and reliability. So it's going to be a catalyst
for a lot more products in the fintech space. And that's amazing, because that can also be used in financial inclusion.
Correct.
Can you also provide a more specific example so that this, you know, this is more para understandable for the layman?
Because we're only studying wholesale CBDC, the more direct application for retail is something that will be maybe a second phase for us.
Right.
Once we've gotten around some of the legal implications and requirements of our charter. But just as an example, the National Treasury is actually launching tokenized treasury bonds next
week.
So right now they're a little institutional, institution to institution, but they want to go down to the retail level. If we had the retail CBDC, that could partner with that. But that's, you know, but that's
down the line.
Yeah, that,
but that's exciting.
Yes, it is exciting. But first, we have to actually learn in the BSP how CBDC works.
Yeah.
I don't know if I mentioned to you earlier, we did a book in 2020 to explore that, how central bank digital currencies could actually help us in our three pillars, monetary policy, financial stability, and safe and efficient national payment system. We have done enough of the desktop research. I think that's it. So we wanted to really do, you know, a pilot under a regulated environment. So we have six participants. I can mention the names.
Yes.
BDO Union Bank, Maya, RCBC, China Bank. Who did I miss? Sorry if I missed
someone,
but there's six of them. So we wanted to do abroad, like you have like large commercial banks, mid-sized commercial banks. And when we started this, Maya was not yet at the
bank. Oh, wow. So, yeah. Finally, they got in.
So we wanted to
just in time.
That's right.
The tokenized bonds of the Bureau of Treasury, that's already, that will be part of...
It will be launched next week.
Yes, when it's launched next week. Is it going to work, or is it the settlement for that
settlement
will not
for
yet
that
be?
Will still be with Philpass.
Ah, okay. All right, but that's exciting.
Yeah,
also.
But that's a possible use case later on.
Now the timeline. Let us talk about the timeline. So you started the study in 2020, and then what happened afterwards?
After the study in 2020, I told you we said enough desktop, so we'll get our hands dirty and do it. So we actually already, as I mentioned, we are hiring a tech provider. We're using DLT, which is the most prevalent technology among all CBDCs.
The DLT is your
distributed ledger technology,
which is a subset of the blockchain.
Yes.
We are anti-tech here. Technical terms.
Yes.
Jargon.
So we have hired. We have six participants, as I mentioned. We'll do a sandbox, so test and learn, and hopefully, after we've done the sandbox, we will come up with a report by the middle of next year.
Wow!
And with that report, we will be able to tell, you know, fintech providers that this is what we learned and this is what we actually want to do, and hopefully that can help create a roadmap with the use cases that you mentioned before.
Right.
The use cases, you know, many other things have come out of it.
And moving forward, how soon before it can actually be launched for use by the entire system?
I don't want to promise anything because we're still just learning.
Studying.
Yeah.
So there is no definite yes or no yet. It's a study.
It's a study.
It's
right?
a study.
What will come out of our pilot test is an actual report. It's an assessment. So it will help us decide where we will bring this.
Ms. Edna, let's look at the big picture. CBDC is one of the most controversial topics after what happened with the cryptocurrency world. But it's supposed to be providing the same benefit as security, speed, less cost in moving money, not just here within the Philippines, but also around the world. What else gives us more confidence in something like this? What will it do for us?
The difference between the current coins, whatever currencies that you mentioned earlier, is that they're not backed by the central bank. The CBDC has the full guarantee of the central bank, and so therefore it is safe.
Right. And that will provide all of the benefits of the digital currency world. Thank you so much, Ms. Edna. This has been such a pleasure.
Thank you very much.